Solve. X squared minus 2x plus 2 equals 0. This is a quadratic equation, and let's solve it using the quadratic formula. Again, to use the quadratic formula, we need the quadratic equation in the standard form. That's ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. This is in the standard form. Let's pick out our a, b, and c. Okay, our a, that's the coefficient of x squared. That's a 1 there. So if you don't see a coefficient, you can imagine a 1 times x squared just gives you x squared. So I'll write a equals 1. Next we have our b. Our b is the coefficient of x. So b equals negative 2. Now I know this says plus bx. You can think of it, if it helps you, you can write this plus negative 2x, if that straightens it out. But it is a negative 2. B is negative 2. Okay, C. C is our constant term. That is 2. C equals 2. So we have our A, B, and C, and the reason we want to pick those off is for the quadratic formula. And remember that quadratic formula is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, and it's the square root of all of that, all over 2a. Okay, so let's take our a, b, and c values and plug this into the quadratic formula. I'll switch to another color, and let's go. X equals the opposite of b. Well, if b is negative 2, then the opposite of b is positive 2. So I'm going to write 2 plus or minus the square root of b squared. Again, this is negative 2 quantity squared. And we'll come back and get negative 2 times negative 2 there. Minus 4 times our a is 1 and our c is 2. So we've got the square root of all of that. All over 2a. All over 2 times our a is just 1. Okay, now let's start to simplify. X equals 2 plus or minus the square root of negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. 4 minus 8 is negative 4. We're going to do something with that square root of a negative because that'll give a non-real solution. Okay. We cannot cancel a 2 out here because this 4 is still, this negative 4 is still under the radical. Well, we have a square root of a negative number, so we're going to need to factor that as, I'll write the rest of it here, 2 plus or minus, the square root of 4 times the square root of negative 1. 4 times negative 1 is negative 4. And the reason we do that is because this square root of negative 1 has a special value. We call it I, and I'll just put that up in the corner here so we remember that. The square root of negative 1 equals, we call it I. It's part of our imaginary number system. Okay, so instead of writing square root of negative 1, we will write I. Now again, this is all over, I better finish this. This is all over 2. Now, x equals 2 plus or minus, the square root of 4 is just 2, so I'll write 2. Square root of negative 1 is I, as we have over here. This is all over 2. Now, typically, when you have an I, an imaginary component, you're going to write these as fraction. And in this case, the 2's are going to cancel out. So this will be kind of a nice little answer for us. So x equals 2 over 2 plus or minus 2 over 2i, just to show step by step. Okay, we can cancel these out, and we have x equals 1 plus or minus 1 times I, or just I. Now again, these are two distinct solutions. We have two solutions here. We have 1 plus I, and we also have 1 minus I. Those are two distinct solutions to that quadratic equation. So those are non-real. They're in the complex number system or the imaginary number system, but they are the solutions to this equation.